My name is, for people that don't know, my name is William Walker Jr. And I was born and raised in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And I had an angry childhood, and confusion and a lot of violence, domestic violence. But I was always thankful for the fact that one of the parents in the home always prayed and talked about Jesus, always went to church, always just trying to go for God. So it was a blessing. But it was another parent that just liked the streets. And I had to grow up with them both. So I was really confused as a child growing up. Didn't understand that Jesus was the right way. And I was only going off of what was modeled in front of me. And as far as the streets, I was going only going off what was modeled in front of me. But I always had this thing deep down inside of me where I knew I was meant for something greater, but I didn't know how to get to it because of my surroundings and the darkness that I was surrounded by. And it took me a very long time to come to the light. A very long time to come to the light. Dibbled and dabbled into a lot of stuff. None of it fit me. As far as gangs go, drugs, it never really suited me. It fit me. It wasn't never really my thing. It was an itch I couldn't get scratched. But I was surrounded by all of that. And I had an opportunity to pursue any of that. I had an opportunity to be a dope boy. I had an opportunity to be a hustler or a pimp or whatever. And I never had opportunities. It was so far-fetched. Where I was growing up, to be a doctor. But my parents always told me that I could be a doctor. But it was only a certain amount of options you had where I was growing up, and that was either to be a drug dealer or to be good at sports or to go to school and be really smart. And where I was raised and where I was coming from, my options were slim. I grew up kind of rough, and I was good at sports, and it was a blessing. I got taught sports. I was aware I got a lot of anger and aggression out with sports, and even though I did all these things and dabbled in all these things, and still I had just longing inside of me that I knew was more than what society was offering me. And I was jumped into a gang to being a gang member. I was jumped in to be a Crip. And I was beat up so bad that I can barely walk. But God had a plan. I've been in prison, fighting, thrown in a hole. The gun went off in close range. The bullet shot past my head, but it didn't stop me. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Amen. Nothing will never be able to separate me from the love of God. Not death, not hell, not a demon, not principalities, nothing high, nothing low, will never be able to stop me from getting to the love of God. I sold drugs, crack cocaine to make some money to feed myself. But God had a plan. I got saved and filled with the Holy Spirit in the church parking lot. I grew up Baptist. I was the oldest child of my household, so oftentimes I would go try to sell drugs to feed my siblings. Because that was the situation that I was in. And I was turning on to sex at an early age in perverted ways with perverted people. I got divorced in my 20s. She wasn't a Christian. And I was born again believer, so it didn't work out. So she left me and I checked myself into the Dream Center. I left my kids and everything that I thought was important that I needed in my life to follow Jesus. I totally surrendered my life to him. And what I found out, even after all that surrendering that I did and killing the flesh and ministering to people that's in predicaments that you're not in, you still have to surrender. There's still more surrendering to do. And that's for me personally. I still got to surrender even more. I thought I surrendered and I'm going to have a clean time of freedom from surrendering from Christ and a break. But I guess not. I got to keep surrendering and getting closer to him because he wants everything. So I thought it was important that I needed to follow Christ, so that's why I checked myself in here. And I graduated. I did the 6 months. It was hard. Very hard, strict. Met a lot of brothers in there, you know, all men. It was a good opportunity. And I also spent time in a mental hospital, cutting myself when I was young. I OD'd off ecstasy. But today, in spite of all this, I still have Jesus. And I'm happily married today. Beautiful wife, Patty Dawn Walker. And I have 7 beautiful kids and a beautiful church that preaches the word of God. And a beautiful church family that love others and live generously. And it's all because God had a plan that will end. I would like to end with a scripture. Romans 8:28. And we know that all things work together for the good of them who love God and who are called according to his purpose. God had a plan.